See, we spoke to your brother, the Florida representative, and I like talking to you guys. I like the vibe. You guys are like real, and you're smart, and you're saying, no, that's good. But people want that, right? People are upset about Washington. And let's spin it to that now. What do you feel is the biggest impediment to economic growth and jobs now? Is it the tax structure that's so burdensome and all the lobbying and it's so long? Would reform and simplification and broadening out help us? Is it the overburdened regulation at the state level and the federal level? Is it this debt overhang? What's the biggest thing you guys can do in Washington to help get the economy going again?
Well, I have a bill actually out there right now, and it's threefold. It's the two things that you said. It's the corporate tax structure, which, you know, we're second, I think, behind Japan in the most hostile place to do business. Yeah. That can't happen. At 35% corporate tax rates, they need to come down to at least 25. So people say, hey, this is a good country to do business in, or I'm not going to move my country abroad because I'm happy where I'm at and I can grow, you know,
it's
I can grow.
Global market now, yeah, global competition,
right,
for business.
That's right. And so, you know, what's going to make me want to create jobs? It's a feeling that I know that I'm not going to have this oppressive tax code, as well as the regulation. I mean, that is huge. When people talk about regulation, they sort of like glaze over, you know, but there's a lot of things that the bureaucracy in Washington, D.C. protects themselves by creating these regulations. And, you know, there's one real estate market that's not in trouble, and that's Washington, D.C., because there's a lot of high-paying jobs. And the last thing is a lack of courage, really, and that comes with a lot of things that people are talking about today. It's energy exploration. It's the ability to say, hey, we're not going to keep getting in fights all across the world with these countries just because we're worried about what might happen with our oil prices. We have a plethora of options in this country.
Right,
we should be exploring all those. We can't be deterred by the fact that, oh, well, what if another BP happens? Well, that is a role of government. Let's make sure that doesn't happen again. But let's not just de facto say, we're not going to do it. We're going to rely on Venezuela or Iran or these countries that don't like us to make sure that we're all driving cars, we're all flying around in airplanes, so, you know.
Put your head in the ground, got to confront the issue and handle it.
That's right, and that's a lot of jobs. And, you know, some people say, well, you know, it's questionable whether there's a lot of jobs there. I disagree with that, but at the very least, it will make our country a lot more wealthy. And Florida, you know, we always talk about the tourism here, the banking industry, and the housing industry. But, I mean, if you add energy on top of that, it will make Florida come back like that.
That's really big. This guy's on point. I love this. I can talk to you all day. Now,